Good morning. Welcome to our Sunday service. My name is Pastor Glen Winston, 310 Salem, Conway, Arkansas. This is our first Sunday of May. Look, we've been talking about it Wednesday. If you've been following us, that hey, it's first Sunday. And so we're going to get into the Word of God. I hope you've been following us. I always say the Word is taking us somewhere. And last Wednesday, we was talking about Daniel, coming out of Daniel 3. We began to talk about the three Hebrew boys when God led them through the fire. They didn't lead God in the fire. God led them in the fire. And that's what we're going to be talking about a little bit today. So we're going to get into the scripture today. 1 Corinthians. We're going to be in 1 Corinthians, the third chapter. And we're going to start at the 10th verse. It says, according to the grace of God, which given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid a foundation. And another therefore build upon. But let every man take heed how he build thereupon. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Let's bow our heads and let's pray. Father God, we thank you. We praise you. God, we thank you for this day we never seen. God, we thank you, God, for your fresh anointing. God, we thank you, God, for fresh breathing of wind, God. We thank you for who you are. And we thank you for giving us Jesus Christ that we can come spotless. Even simple, but the blood of Jesus washes white as snow and protect us and watches over us. Well, you don't see our fault, but you see the blood of Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord, everyone. You know, just knowing Jesus, just know who Jesus are and just know what he does. It means a whole lot. Wisdom is powerful and we need to know. And here we begin to talk about Paul, begin to talk about a wise master builder, talking about Jesus laid the foundation and we build that bone. And so we know that Jesus Christ said he's the chief cornerstone, but the builders have rejected him. And we're going to talk about today because we see that Daniel, we were talking about the Hebrew boys in Daniel 3, was talking about them when Nebuchadnezzar, King Nebuchadnezzar, was over Babylon and God allowed him to overtake his peoples, to just put them, some, a remnant was saved that God was going to bring back. He was just really they servant to watch over them, really, just keep them in place, basically. But that's not the way it was. He was as a king. He had overtaken God peoples, and they was in captivity. But as I look spiritually, he was just keeping over a remnant that God was going to bring back. Because through that remnant, you begin to see when they went in captivity, you had an Esther. Esther Rose. I seen the other day they had on Erica Camel radio show. They was talking about women's making up. Makeup and donning themselves and doing and everything. And so ask the men what to think about it. But I seen what Sarah said. She said, don't don the outer, don the inner, you know, for Christ. And so there go Esther. I remember when Esther went in and met the king, she did not put on, because they told him, say, whatever you put on, you get a chance to keep. She didn't put on a bunch of jewelry. She didn't put on them fancy robes. She took that one little rose and her purity self. Her purity self, listen, women, took her purity self in there. And that king chosen her because the other women's, whatever they put on, they were able to keep, even if they were just going to be a concubine. So when they got, they didn't have confidence. They were getting said, well, this is what I'm going to have. This is going to be mine, that little bit. But what she did, she took her purity self in the end, and she took a rose when she met the king. And the king chosen her because she was so purity. And God favors upon her life. When God favors on your life, you ain't got to adorn yourself up, dress yourself up, or pretend yourself. You just got to show up and be yourself. Praise the Lord. So in other words, when they went in captivity, that was Nehemiah. That was Daniel. That was all this anointing was going to raise up out of there. Out of being in captivity. So that's why I called Nebuchadnezzar. He just really was a servant, just watching over as God was building his people. Jeremiah 29 was telling him, say, look, while you're here, marry, build houses, find peace as much you can. He said, because He said, God says he know the plans and thoughts he have for you, not to bring you home, but to prosper you and got great expectations for you. So in captivity, the anointing was raising up because God was finna bring out a remnant of people as they begin to Nehemiah, cupbearer, crying, goes back, get favor to start putting the walls of Jerusalem back up, the gates up. Praise the Lord in here. So here we go. Here we go. Here he's saying, be careful. I'm a wise master build. Be careful how you build on. And so we're looking at Daniel now when that King Nebuchadnezzar had built this high tower, this man image, and built this great image, and had got all the prince, the rulers, the chief staff, the counselors. He had got the calendar. He got everybody that was anybody to come worship it, you know, and they weren't going to do it. And they had made a decree when the sound of a day, a time of a day, when the harps and everything go off, the music, stop what you're doing, bow down and worship this deal. See, God never lets some be for nothing. Always have a plan. The enemy may look like he's doing something great, but he's not. It's just a setup. And God, people did not bow down to it. And they begin to, Chaldeans did not like Daniel. And them so begin to tell us, well, look, anybody don't burn down, do that. We need to make a decree with them. And so they did. And so what happened? Then they saw they wasn't. The Jews are not doing it. Well, they called them in. They said, we're not going to do it. Praise the Lord. And then they begin to tell them, say, well, if God's for us, he'll protect us. And if he can take us from out of your hand. But if he don't, it's fine. See, God was leading them into that for a day we can see something. We should never bow down to everything that the world put up. But what we do as a body of Christ, we bow down. And so the Bible says in Romans 8, who led by the Spirit of God is a son of God. And we have to know we have to be led. And so by God and not by man. So we got to understand here is that this big idol, when he bought the governors, everybody bowed down. That's the way the world today. They bowing down to anything. Everybody that's supposed to be wise men running the earth, they bow down to anything. But here it says, Jesus Christ laid the foundation, and we're supposed to be wise master builders. Be careful how we build that upon. We're supposed to be careful. Now, them Hebrew boys, did they lead God into the fire, or did God lead them? God led them into the fire, like Moses was led to the wilderness for 40 years. You got to understand, situations look like you may be doing it, but it's God doing it. And God led them in that furnace of fire, and God brought them out of that fire. And God brought them out, but not smelling like smoke. They had the clothes, the hat, they had all the garments on. They bound them all. And King Nebuchadnezzar looked in and said, he said, didn't we put in three? They said, yeah. They said, look like there's a fourth in there. It looked like the Son of God. Now, how did he know that it was the Son of God? They had not seen Jesus. They didn't know. But said, the fourth one, like the Son of God. And what they know about was the Son of God. Why? How did they know that? Because King Nebuchadnezzar, even though he was the opposite of his Jews, God had touched him to be able. God can touch the world, then be able to watch over his people and to bring them in captivity and know what to do. And so never that no weapon formed against us should prosper, because everything, God got his hands in everything, bad or good, he has it. And so that's why I like this, because it gets so deep and make our mind realize no matter what goes on, we have to serve God. And so what we're saying is that we'll say, God be with me. Oh, God, walk with me. But do you walk with God? We need to let God lead us through the storm and not us leading God in our little storm. We have to be led. You know, look at the Bible. The Bible say when he told Abraham, leave your people, go out, I got a place I want to show you. He said, take no relatives with you. But guess what Abraham did? He let Lot went with him. And what ended up happening? Lot had to separate from him. Look at this. You got to watch your sometimes people that's led by God, and the people try to follow them that is led by God, and end up causing trouble. And a lot of times, that's what it got to be careful about how you build on. Look at David's son. David was anointed. David's son wanted to come against him, wanted to take the kingdom, because when his half-brother raped his sister, because they had half-brother and sister, because David had a lot of wives. And guess what? He felt like David wasn't dealing with this right. So he wanted to take the kingdom, take it in hand. Careful about being round anointed. He ended up getting killed. He ended up, his hair was long, got riding a horse, and it was trying to come at David now, and he ended up getting killed. It hurted David, because David didn't even want him killed. So David, right-hand man, had said kill him. So what happened? David already had an envy in him because he walked close with David. When he told Solomon, he said, you better watch him. But if Solomon ended up having him killed, and when he tried to come against Solomon, he got killed in the temple holding the horn. So you got to watch people when they hang out with anointed people. Because when he's walking with them, you got to be careful. Look at Elijah and Gehazi. Elijah noted one time when Naaman come to him, and he told Gehazi, go out there and tell him, go and dip yourself in Jordan River. Well, Naaman didn't really want to do that. He felt Elijah would come out and wave his hand over and speak some big words because he was a valiant man. But he just had leprosy. But Naaman, what he did is that his servant told him, said, do what he said do. And so he should do it. And he did. He got clean. But Elijah wouldn't take nothing from him. But Gehazi sworn, long as the Lord live, I'm going to go and get some of that. What happened to the person walking in anointing? The same thing. Elijah said, wasn't my heart with you when you went and did all that and got that? He said, now you and your house, the same leprosy was up on Naaman, now is up on you. Because one thing, when you're led by God, you don't play with people. And you wonder why I'm being done like this. Because you know that's not what we supposed to did. You know that's not what's supposed to happen. And so you got to understand. You got to be careful. When God begin to lead anointed people, you can cause hectic in their life because of you hanging around with the anointing. But look at Joshua. After Joshua go over there and get Jericho and do everything they had to do, Joshua goes back out to war. He take very few people because you know God with him. He come back and almost got slaughtered. He come back, put his head in the dirt, praying and going on and doing. God, where you at? What's wrong? And then an angel come up. Joshua jumped up. Say, you for me or against me? And he began to tell him he was sin of the Lord. And he told him, say, look, you got sin in your account. You got to go and get it out and get rid of it. You know what Joshua did? Joshua went back and called all families out. Said, we're going to search your house. We're going to see what's going on. And Achan said, hey, it's me. Because Achan had took from Jericho that would belong to God and to get him and put it on his bed. And he would end up killing Achan, his wife, his children, everything he had. He got it out the camp. Why? Because when you are led by God, when God give you a word, you got to be careful how you build on. Else you'll be trying to love God and arguing with people that are disobedient with God. And so that's what they say. We have to be careful how we build on. Because people around you can have other angles. They can go and do something for you, but then they have other angles. But Ephesians 6 begin to let us know about that. And Ephesians 6 begin to tell us. It begin to tell us about the whole armor of God. It says, this is power, my brother. He say, be strong in the Lord. And the power is might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wildness of the devil. Therefore wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. And so he began to tell us. But then he tell us in verse 6, verse 1, he said, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy mother and father, which is the first commandment, and the promise, that ye may dwell with thee, and thou may live a long life. So there's rules of the master builder. But people want to go and build their houses the way they want to. They got different angles. It's not the, we say we love God. God say he's a chief stone, and we, and when we go, don't use him, and whatever our title is, as a child, we're supposed to obey our parents so we can live a long life. We're supposed to love them. And so we're supposed to plumb off of that. And so if we come to be a husband, a father, we're supposed to provide for our family. If we come to be a wife, you're supposed to obey that man. Now, I know you're mad at me, but I don't care. He said, we're supposed to cleanse the earth, supposed to have children, supposed to do and do us right. That's what he said. But see, what we don't understand, we build it another way. Say, God, where you at? You wonder now, will you build your house? Windows is off, the doors is locked, you can't shut none. Nothing ain't working. Why? You had another angle. It wasn't God angle. God ain't gonna have a title for each and every one of us what we're supposed to do. Let's look at this a little further. And he goes on and says right here in verse 4, and fathers, and ye father, revoke not the children to wrath, but bring them up in the natural of the admiration of the Lord. And we wonder why our children are the way they are and why they doing. We have a title of we have to stand up and we have to do what God say do, and we wonder why we get the opposite. And verse 5 said, servant, master, according to the flesh, with fear and trembling, in the single of your heart, as unto Christ. not with eye service as man pleasers, but doing the will of God in your heart. So he tell people, he tell them this. He said, look, when you go and do something, don't do it just to be seen. Don't go and tell them, well, I've done this, I've done. No, just getting a big old hoop-a-doo crowd. No, he said, be careful how you build on. Then you wonder why your windows rot, when you wonder why things ain't working for you. Because that's another angle. That's not what God told you to do. So we have to be careful. When God tells us something, we have to build as wise master builders. And he says this here, with good will do service as unto the Lord and not unto men, knowing that whosoever good thing any man does, the same shall he receive of the Lord, whether he be bond or free. And ye masters, do the same unto them that forbear and treat, knowing that your master also in heaven, neither there is no respectable person of him. So he tell masters, because I'm your master in heaven, so I may give you a little authority, but you don't go and use go against your authority. So he says, knowing that you have a master in heaven. So he began to tell us how we build. God began to tell us how we are. And so that's the reason why other people have other angles and wonder why things messed up. Because you know why? You have not built it the way God did. You didn't accept your title. You didn't step in it. You had a generation curse. You seen somebody else build it. And that's why your house messed up. That's why your house messed up. And that's why Daniel and them did not bow down. They did not bow down to that idol. They did not bow down because everybody else was doing it. And they said, we are not going to do it. But God is able to deliver us. God took them through that fire. And God. And sometimes we got to trust God what God says to us. And this is what he began to say here. He said, follow my brother. Be strong in the Lord. And the of God, that you may be able to stand against the wildness of the devil. He said, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Therefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil days. Have done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with the truth, and have on the breastplate of righteousness, and your foot shone with the preparation of the gospel of peace. And above all, take the shield of faith with thee, and says, and shall be able to quench all the fiery darts. And that's what he says. He says, in the heaven of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. We have to take what God tells us to do. We have to stand. We have to build God's house the way he has said. Don't get scared to build it. And we get scared. I'm not going to do that. I'm gonna get married, but I'm not going to be that. I'm going to do this, but I'm not going to do that. And that's messed up. You never feel your title what God said you are. Of your child or your servant. We have not built what God said. You're supposed to be what you're supposed to be. You're supposed to be the best worker you go on your job. You're supposed to be the best husband. You're supposed to be the best wife. You're supposed to be the best child. And that's the reason why we messed up. Because things are messed up. Because how we build on, that's how we get. So we go back to 1 Corinthians, and it says that Paul says, he said, and I, brethren, could not speak unto you as on the spiritual, but as carnal, even as on babes in Christ. I meet, for hereabout we were not able to bear it, neither yet now ye are able. He said, whether thou must you with envy and strife and division. Ye not call, walk as men. I am Paul. And another say, I'm a not call. Who then is Paul? Who is Apollos? But ministers, by whom ye believe, even as the Lord give to every man. And I have planted, Apollos watered, but God give the increase. So then, plant anything, neither that watered, but God give the increase. Now he that planted and he that watered are one, but every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. He's together with Christ. Ye are God husband. Ye are God builders, according to the grace which God give unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation and another builder on. But every man take heed how he build their own. And that's what Paul was saying. We got to be careful. And everybody wondering, why my life twisted? Why my life messed up? Why this messed up? Are you doing according to the type what you put to do? And now you want to point fingers at everybody else. Nobody else got nothing to do with that house. You build that house. God said, listen, you know, you build that. That's not the way I said build it. You something else different that I told you to do, and now you don't like what you built. But my mama said, if you make your bed, you got to lay in it. And so, in other words, if you go and build it, the doors won't shut, you're gonna get mad. Who would go and get a house and you give them this blueprint and they come back and build you something totally opposite? Are you gonna want that house? Are you gonna be satisfied with that house? God said, I have a blueprint. Build it. Be careful. Build that. I did not build that. Now you want me to walk with you with this? You want me to agree with you with this? You want me to bow down to this God you done made? This worldly God? You want me to be in the wilderness? That's what he said. Somebody give you this if you're about it. You think I'm a God, where you at? God said, no, I'm wondering where you at. That's not the blueprint your mama showed you. You didn't build it the way your daddy done showed you. You didn't build it the way your siblings done showed you. You ain't built this the way I told you to build. And you begin to wonder, well, what's wrong? Well, what's wrong? You built that. You had another angle. Gazer had another angle. Akron had another angle. Lot had another angle. Come on, don't make me talk this. So it says right here, verse 11. He say, for another foundation can no man lay that is laid, which is Christ. You can't change it. God already got it. You got to build on. Be careful. He said, how if any man build up on the foundation, gold, silver, or precious stones, or wood, or hay, or stubble, every man work shall be made manifest. For the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by the fire. And the fire shall try every man work or source of it. That's funny how it's saying that in the end it will be built by fire. Look at Daniel and them. They went through, the Hebrew boys went through, and the fire built that they was God people, that God led them in. Everything was God. They weren't bowing down. It was God. And the many things, brothers and sisters, in our life and our families and everything goes on, it's how we build something. It's how we do something. In the scripture, and here was, if you go on in here, it tells us, don't look up to man, what man do. Don't honor man and his things. Because that was Nebuchadnezzar wanted everybody to honor him, to look up to him. But it's saying, don't honor him. It was saying here, we should honor what God says. Let's be a Roman 8, and goes on 12, 13, 1 and 2, it says that who's led by the Spirit, they're sons of God. See, God got certain people, he lead them, and no matter what they go through, no matter what come at them, no matter how I do, he know there's going to be other tricky people want to say, well, I want to work for you and be a carpenter and start building something different. You can even be building, got other people working for you. They do something different, and they wonder why you go off, because that's not the way it was. I had a gentleman once when he was teaching me how to weld. I was going to build this barbecue grill that God showed me, and this guy was a master welder. He had a prints of master welder. But he gonna show me the grill he made. I said, come on, you kidding me? But God had, I wasn't a master welder, but God had gave me the blueprint. Just like God had gave Solomon how to build a temple with the masons, the master builders. He knowed how he wanted. I know how this was. And the man girlfriend told him, see, why you just don't do what he wants to do? In the process, I had to learn how to finish welding that. And the guy quit. And the grill come out like, it's awesome. And he seen that I was learning too quick. He wanted to be in control so he can just do things where he want to. He couldn't handle following the blueprint, what I asked him to do. And with issues like that, we're going to have trouble. Because when God showed me something, that's what I'm sticking with. And that's what you got to learn to do. Stick with what God show you. Don't let somebody, because they're a master or they've been doing this way longer than you, you say, this is what God's showing me. And this is the way it's going to go. That would bring on new ideas and bring things we had never seen before. And it says this right here. Verse 14. If any man work abide which he have built upon, he shall receive a reward. If any man work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but himself shall be saved, yet so by the fire. Knowing ye that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwell in you. And if any man defile the temple of God, he shall be destroyed. Shall God destroy of the temple of God is holy, which are ye. And it say, which are ye? He says, verse 18, I have to say this. Let no man deceive himself. If any man amongst you seem to be wise in this world, let him come to be foolish, that he may be wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolish with God. For it is written, he that takes the wise in his own craftiness. And again, the Lord know the thought of the wise, that they are vain. Therefore, let no man glory in man, for all things are yours. See, that's what he said. When them boys did not bow down to King Nebuchadnezzar, they did not bow down to him. They said, no, we are not going to praise this. We're not going to the temple of God. We are the anointing of God. We are the remnant of God to give the anointing the chance to get back in his place. We got to be able to do it. We have to be able to how we build on, because we got a master that is telling us just the way it got to go. So whatever I go through that situation, God will bring me out. Whatever I go through, it may not look it's going to work, but God was going to make me out. Bring me out. One thing God told me about my grandson, Landon, he said, he says, don't matter what he go through, and it may look like he's not, but he always come through. It will come to pass like God said. I never forget that what God said, because that's the way my lifestyle is. It may look like it's not going to happen, but it will. It will come through, and that's the pattern that God told me with me. He says, the same thing going to be with him. He said, it's going to come out. It's going to work out. It's going to come to pass. Because whatever God said before, it'll come to pass. God has said one thing, talk how beautiful his skin is going to be. Well, the enemy tried to attack him, but his skin is so beautiful today. Enemy tried to attack him, but God brought it out beautiful. He brought it out better. Why? Because when you're led by God, oh, glory be to God. I'm going to shout in here. I say, when you're led by God, glory be to God. We have to know that God got us. And we're going to run to Daniel 3 real quick, and we're going to get ready to close with this. Glory be to God. Now, after Daniel went to and everything went to and the Hebrew boys went to and God had blessed them and they did not had come out in front of Nebuchadnezzar, then verse 28, Nebuchadnezzar spake and saying, blessed be the God of Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego, who have sent his angel and delivered his servant that trust in him. You hear what he said? Trust in him. His servant trusted in him. And he delivered them. He said, and shall change the king's word and yield their bodies, and they might not serve or worship any god except their own God. There are some people cannot worship another god. God help. Or how you do, or how you try to take them out, or how you try to talk about them. They got some in them. They are made to worship God. And another thing, they are anointed to carry the anointing somewhere else further. So you got to be careful when you're messing with your Abraham, your Elijahs, and them guys, because the people that hang out with them can get taken out because they have some in them special. Don't how close you walk with them. Don't close how you hang out with them. You just cannot fool with them boys because they got something that God have put in them, and they are God people to carry out his will. In verse 29, he said, therefore, I make a decree that every which speak anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut into pieces, and their houses shall be made into dung, because there is no other God that can deliver after this sort. He said, listen, the God they serve, let me tell you something. is no other God can do it. Y'all can say anything you want to say. Can't nobody do this right here, what them guys did. Because why? They was made to give God glory. They were made to go through. They were made to look like, hey, look, they not going to make it. They were made to look like that it was over for them. But God led them in. How many times are we leading God in our stuff because we ain't done what God told us to do? And we wondering why we it's all messed up. Because you rejected the chief cornerstone. You rejected Jesus Christ. You rejected God. God have a blueprint for you. He have a life for you. He have a better thing for you. He got a better way for you. But you know what? And what they do, they can't help themselves. So you know what? We have to understand Ephesians 6, let us know how to do, how we supposed to do. Don't go and do something for somebody else and then hoo ha rah with somebody else. Your labor was in vain because you're trying to popping yourself up. If you do something, forget about it. You do it from your heart unto God and not unto man. If you can't do that, don't do that. Leave that alone. God ain't told you to leave it alone. Glory be to God. So verse 30 says, then the king promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the province of Babylon. Now you understand, the Chaldeans did not like these boys. They want these boys taken out. Because these boys turn around and worship the God. They had the true living God. God had put something in them. He had anointed them to be that. He was anointed them that no weapon that formed against them shall prosper. He anointed them that they are his chosen people. He anointed them. They might be look like they in trouble, might be all messed up. But he have anointed them because somebody got to let them know and show them that they God. Some people, well, God, I don't know why you're good to him. I don't know why you're still. Okay, I'm going to let you put them there, but I'm going to show you. No, because why? I have realized after a while that's mine. Because when you worship, but I'm not bound down to death. Is who he is, who he say is. He will do what he said do. Ain't no justified word. So when you step on their toe, they start trying to justify something. No, when you are a man of God, a woman of God, you believe with the word of God, it's no justifying. God's word is what it is, and you can't change his word. His word is the same yesterday and today. Enemy can no weapon that can be formed against you that can God. It may not look good. They may talk about you. They may. But if you are led by God and you trust him, God will bring you through. No matter what come at you, God will bring you through. Because there's something in you. There's something in you. And the scripture says, great is he in you than the man in the world. Because when you got something that can lead you to anywhere, they won't lead you at. You know, I heard a song the other day, and it's true. Say, God, favor ain't fair. Say, God, keep on blessing me when he should. He keep on watching on me when he should. You just keep on blessing me. And we got to be careful how we build up on the foundation that's given to us with a chief master builder. And we realize that, oh, my house messed up and the door won't shut and this, nothing going right. Well, God have a title for us, and your title, you have to step in it. And we can't not keep going, God, to lead us in a path. We have to follow him because the Bible says, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. He making me lie down in green pastures. He lead me beside still waters. He restored my soul for his name's sake. Yea, I walk through the valley of shadow and death where none don't live. The mountains tall, sun don't come in, none can grow. I shall have word watches over me, protect me, don't matter where I'm at. Prepare the in the presence of my enemies trying to trap me. Just don't like me because of the world. The Bible say the world gonna hate you because the world the love of their own. You wonder why things in the world don't work for you. Every time something go down, you miss out on it. It ain't meant for you because you're not of the world. God is your provider. He's your Jehovah Jireh. And so you got to understand that he said, well, put a table for me in the presence of my enemies, anoint my head, my cup will runneth over. Oh, come on. He will anoint my head, my cup will runneth over. But put a table for me in the presence of my enemy, because I stayed on the word of God, because God got plans. Because the Bible says in Ephesians 1, he knew me in verse 4 before the foundation of the world, put in me his good pleasure. He done made me go through this. He done made me have to stand on the word of God. He done let man look at wise and look at smart and let them do and miss and talk. But God knows he already has something in his people to give him glory. So if I put a table on my head, chosen with anointing on me, he said, my cup of goodness, my cup is representing what I'm going to drink. It's going to run it over. It ain't going to stop. Ain't going to be thirsty. It's going to quench anything come at me. God, you greater than that. Anything try to trap me, God, you greater than that. Anything come hurt me, God, you greater than that. Any sickness come up on me, God, you greater than that. Any bill, God, you greater than that. My cup shall run it over, my joy. And I should dwell in the house of the Lord forever. See, when God is our shepherd, he lead us. He give us a blueprint. And the enemy try to do something different. Try to sell us a wooden nickel, they used to say. Some won't spin, go another way. And we still say, God's okay. You must let me win here. But it's okay, God, you're able. You're able. See that's what they said. And then they made a decree. You know what they made a decree? They said, look, every tongue, every language, but not even say a mist about them boys, God. Because what God can do, what he have done for you. What God can do, what God have bought you from. What God can do, what God have saved you from being drunk and could have been in car wrecks and places that was a club that you could have been killed and protected you and washed over you. What God, but our Lord and Savior. When you didn't even know him, he had plans for you. Oh, you should go in and shout right there. I said, when you didn't even know him, he had plans for you. And protected and watched over you and brought you a mighty long way. Because why? He have laid a foundation for you. He said, build on, baby. But be careful how you build. Because I learned, I used to have those little sticky note by my bed a long time ago when I stayed in another house, my first house. And it says, what we do for Christ will last forever. See, what I do here today, it'll last forever. Oh, yeah, it's going to last forever. Ministering the word of God. Look, I want to tell you out there, quit wondering where God's at. Because when we go in Roman 10, it says in 8, we don't say what like this. Likewise, we don't say, who going to go and get him? Who going to bring him up again? See, we don't say that. But we know he neither to our mouth. So could we confess? We begin to speak. We begin to say who he is. We begin to speak it. Because we know we don't have to bring him up and don't have to go and get him. That he's already there. We know that God is already there. We speak like we know he's there. We confess him like we know he's there. We say it like we believe it. And it says this in Roman 10 in verse 6, he said, for the righteous which is of faith speak on this wise, say not in their heart, who shall descend into heaven, that is to bring Christ down from above, or who shall descend into the deep, that shall bring Christ up again from the dead. But what says it? The word is neither even in thy mouth. In thy heart, that is, the words of faith which we speak. It says, for if thou shalt confess with thy mouth Jesus Christ and believe in thy heart that God hath raised him from the dead, shall be saved. For with the heart man shall believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth he confess is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whosoever believe on him shall not be ashamed, for there is no difference between the Jews or the Greek, for the Lord is the same over all his riches unto all that call upon him. So whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. How shall they call on him whom they have never believed? How shall they believe in him whom they have not heard? How shall they hear without a preacher? Now shall they, how shall they preach except they be sent? It is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. That's why I say my labor today is not in vain. Because how can I preach except God sent me? How can you hear without a preacher? How can we do what we do? Because everybody have a position to do. And what I do today lasts forever. And that's why I always says that with Roman 10:8-9. Say, if you believe that Jesus Christ, and you confess with your heart and believe in your heart that God raised from the dead, you are saved. Because with your mouth, you speak on confession. With your mouth, you build. Because God has given you authority. Because he's with you in your dead sin. He put some in you that if you speak it, you got it. What you say, you give it. And so, other words, he said this right here. He said, one increase. I want to leave this note. Whatever you're building, God has given you the increase. If it's wrong, he's giving you increase. Come on, you better talk to me. But you will be accountable in the end. Just because you're getting increase in wrong don't mean it's good. Because you got increase in doing this don't mean it's good. Because say whatever you do, God say, I'm going to increase it. Rather, day of reckoning with it. That you will be justified or you will be, it will be billed that it one of God. So that's why he say, if the world increasing and doing wrong, and they say in Malachi 3, why should we do right? Why should we? The world seem like, he say, look, I got a day, a book of written when I make up my jewels. Because this ain't going to be forever. This is going to be like a twinkle of an eye. We're going to be out of one day and we'll be in heaven. And we'll begin to see everybody get their reward. This will be over. This is not it. This will be destroyed. We looking for a new Jerusalem. We looking for a new heaven. We looking for a new place. We looking past this place. This place is not it yet. So that's why he says, be careful how you build, because I'm giving an increase in whatever you do. God, where I'm at. No, you say, God, stop. Help me. Help me change my life. Help me build. Help me do different. I don't like my life. And this is a little last tip I'm going to give. Problem with a lot of people that messed up a lot of people's lives. You know why? Because you're trying to run somebody else's life, and you ain't got your life the way it's supposed to be. And you faked everybody else. Because you got a generation curse on you. You got to understand, quit trying to run everybody else's life. Get your life right first. Let God be God. Let the master build a bill. And then you will begin to see things change your life. Glory be to God. Hey, look, let's bow heads and let's pray. I'm getting out of here. Praise the Lord. May 1st of the month. Woo, glory be to God. Glory be to God. I got one of my grandson Landon, his birthday this month. Praise the Lord. This is a special month. So we're going to pray. We're going to bow heads. Get out of here. I hope you got something out of it. But I hope that last tip you got it. Because that last tip is a tip I live by. I don't try to straighten nobody else out. I try to straighten me out. To let God do what he do with me. And from there, I try to show my love. My accountability. But don't go around trying to straighten everybody else out. And you wonder why you're torn up. Because God say, no, have you fulfilled your list? What you supposed to be? Fill it. Trust it. Let's bow heads. Father God, we thank you. We praise you. We give you glory. We give you honor in this place today. God, we thank you for being so great. God, I thank you for being who you are. God, increase, God, and more in me. Let me decrease, God, and I want you to increase. God, give me more wisdom. Give me more understanding that I can praise you and give you glory. And God, and do your will, God, that you'll call me to do. God, continue. I need you number one in my life. I need you number one in everything I do, God. God, I have to trust you. God, continue. Give me the faith to trust you and continue, God. Let people hear me say, no, God ain't talking. No, God ain't allowed me to. No, God don't want me to. I got to wait on the Lord. God, I want to thank you. I love you. And God, I want you to continue, God, blessing us with the word of God, watching over us, grooming us, growing us. Lord, we love you. We thank you. No one else like you. Oh, Nebuchadnezzar said it. Don't let no one be able to speak against a God. Oh, God, they house be cut in. God, you're number one. We got to watch our lips and begin to give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. How about that, Jesus? Jesus, they got on the cross and paid for our sin. How about that Jesus that went to hell and took the keys of hell and preached the gospel? And how about that Jesus when he died, the sun didn't shine, earthquake, the dead had started rising, walking down the streets of Jerusalem. How about that Jesus that he rose on the third day? He rose up. He rose up way the throne of grace, and then he sat down to right hand of the Father, and they sent the Holy Spirit back to us. How about that, Jesus? Glory be to God. None like him, won't be none like him, never will be none like him. You know, y'all got tons of miracles out there, just the same as I do. You know what? My mama called him this, sweet Jesus, and that's what he is. You know, there's something about him. I can't wait to get to heaven that I can praise him. It's something about him. It's something when you love him. It's something inside we just can't touch. Have you ever had an itch just way down in your body somewhere and you just can't get it? That's the love of Jesus Christ is inside of me and I just can't get it. I just don't believe I'm going to be able to get that out until I get there and see him one day and begin to give him praise. Brothers and sisters, I pray that same feeling be upon you, that you love him like that and you'll walk like that and you'll talk like that. In Jesus' name we'll pray. Look, my name is Pastor Glendale Winston, Salem 310 Conway, Arkansas. Until we meet again, hey, look, keep on praising the Lord and Savior. God bless you.